friends, in the today's section we are going to talk about how to connect MySQL in PyCharm, means in Python. So open your favorite IDE and let's code. So first here I'm gonna comment here connect to MySQL. So if you don't know what is SQL and MySQL, so why the heck you came here? So first of all, import MySQL. So import MySQL.connector. So you need to install this MySQL from any command prompt, or in the here you can see the terminal, just write pip install MySQL and run it. Okay, mine is already installed, you can see here. Okay, we got MySQL.connector. Now what we are gonna do, is make a DB variable, DB equal to MySQL.connector.connect. So yes, for first argument is host. So you need to install a MySQL, you can see here MySQL workbench, open it. If you don't know how to install, go on YouTube and search for it and download it. When you installing that MySQL software, you need to enter a password and username. So I entered password. First I'm gonna enter host equal to localhost, enter localhost. Now username equal to user equal to, mine is system, and password passwd. Yes, not a full password, only passwd, and mine password is manager. So let's try it. Okay, process finished, exit code 0. Okay, so our SQL is successfully connected. Now what we are gonna do, we are gonna make one new database. Yes, so for that I'm gonna make query, and for that we need to make a new variable named RS, or any variable, or you can say cursor, CURSOR equal to, now cursor equal to db.cursor. You can see here db.cursor. Now what is the cursor? If you know Microsoft Access or some other database platform like MS Access, so cursor is a position when we can put, remove, add, or we can do anything to data. So here cursor equal to db.cursor, we made our cursor. Now we can write any query through this cursor. Okay, so let's see. First query is make a database. So for that cursor dot, you can see the first parameter is the property is execute. Okay, and if you don't know SQL query or how to make table and database, so what the hell are you doing here, man? Let's make a first query, create database. So for that I'm gonna just write create database. But first let's see how many database we got here. So for that, show databases. So it will be showing all the databases in our MySQL. Okay, let's, for that we want to make a loop for, sorry, not here, for, you can name it I in cursor, and for I in cursor, and here you just need to print I. Okay, let's see. And boom, we got so many databases, like example login MySQL, or and so on. So let's create our own database. For just that, you need to write create database and name it, like create database, and I'm gonna name it like code. Yes, so I made a new database. Let's comment here, new database code. Okay, let's run it. But remember, you just need to run only one time this code. When you run it, it will be created. Okay, no problem. But when you run it again, it will be showing error, because you can see can't create database code, database is exist. It will be showing the database is exist. So for that, I'm gonna just comment here. Okay, we got a new database name code. Now let's see, for I in database, sorry, cursor, and print I. And let's, I'm gonna just cursor, make a query, cursor dot execute, and here show databases. Okay, let's run it. We got code or not? Okay, here we got the code database. Let's see in the our MySQL worksheet workbench. Let's reload it through here, you can see, and boom, we got code. But here you can see we have empty table, we have null table. So let's go on PyCharm again and make a table. Okay, for that I'm gonna just do is, first I'm gonna remove it and comment hashtag new table. Okay, let's say we want to make a table of YouTubers. So for that I'm gonna just make a query, for that cursor dot execute, and here you need to just write create table and name it YouTube. Okay, if you don't know this stuff, like how to make create table in MySQL, so show in the video, see in the video in YouTube, search for it. And for that, now I'm gonna just do is YouTube. First I'm gonna, let's see ID, I don't know why I choose ID, but let's say name. Okay, first I'm gonna make simple table name and where care, and I'm gonna 255. Okay, and then I'm gonna subscriber sub SBCRDR. Yes, this is kind of good. Where care 255, and then I'm gonna make a third property, third is, so let's say ID, and ID is number, let's say 5. Okay, we done pretty job here. Okay, let's run it. Oh, we got error. You have an error in MySQL server syntax. Check the manual, the concept, your SQL version of write syntax number. Okay, we got error in number. Okay, this is my mistake. I'm gonna just remove it, and for now I'm gonna just made a two column of name and subscriber. Okay, name and subscriber is good. Now let's remove name and YouTubers YTBRS. Yes, this is good. Let's run it. Okay, no database is selected. Now you need to use a database. So how compiler find which database you are using now? For that you can do is, first you can do is simply here make a query name, simply cursor, let's write isn't printing, yeah, because okay, this is my problem. I made cursor variable here. Let's see. Yes, you can simply do is here, you can write cursor dot execute and simply write cursor dot execute and use code. This is simple. Let's run it. And boom, the error is gone. And you can do other thing, like you can just here make a database equal to code. So this is simple. Okay, let's run it. Oh, if we run this code again, so it will be create another table and we got error. Let's run it. We got error, YouTube is already exist. So for that, okay, we got a table, so let's comment it. Okay, we got table, we got database. So now we are gonna do is, we are gonna just add item in our database. But first, let's see our database, sorry, our table. So for that, I'm gonna just open my MySQL and let's see we got table or not. First I'm gonna refresh it and yes, here's our table. You can see YouTube, we got our table. So you can do both of way to add a row and column. So you can here with cursor dot execute, or you can do here. I'm gonna just do here for fast. Okay, let's create a query. I'm gonna just remove my old stuff here. Okay, let's remove it. You can see here we got nothing. Okay, so now I'm gonna add in my table. So in my code database, I got a one table named YouTube, and in table I'm gonna just add use. First I'm gonna use code. Okay, that's it. And now insert into YouTube values, and now I'm gonna just add value. So like YouTuber is all in one code, and the second one is subscriber. Is let's say my one of the best subscriber is Jaydeep. Okay, and let's run it. So I'm gonna just click here. Okay, or you can just simply write here. You can see I'm gonna just write cursor dot execute and here insert into YouTube and then values, and the value I'm gonna write here is all in one code. Okay, we got some problem here, but we are gonna just remove it later. And I'm gonna subscriber name. Okay, so here you can see we got problem. So remove that. I'm gonna just use, yes, okay, the error is gone. And let's run it. What we got, let's see. Control shift F10 and boom, you can see the process finished code with exit code. Okay, let's see in our MySQL. Let's just refresh it. Open select row limit. Okay, here you can see select star from code.youtube. Okay, here you can see the row is not affected. Why? Because we didn't save that thing. For save, you just need to write is db.commit. Yes, db.commit, it will gonna save our values. Let's control shift F10 and boom, processed code finished with exit code 0. Okay, let's see now. Let's see again. Okay, here you can see all in one code and our subscriber name. Okay, let's try this again. I'm gonna just remove this and I'm gonna enter my favorite YouTuber. Let's say all in one code, all in one and subscriber is, let's say Manish is my subscriber too. Let's run this code, control shift F10, and when I select row limit 100, you can see when I click here, you can see the new row affected and we got all in one and Manish. Okay, so that's how you can enter value in your table, and that's how you can make database and make table. Okay, so let's enter this value from user. Okay, so for that I'm gonna just do is print enter YouTuber name. I'm gonna remove it. Input, yes, copy this and let's say enter subscriber name. Okay, and then I'm gonna make cursor dot execute. And here I'm gonna just write a query. So the query is insert into YouTube, and here I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make this name YT equal to and this name SB. So this value is stored in YT and this value is stored in SB. So I'm gonna just simply make a 2, what is called, I don't know what is called, and in this I'm gonna just write YT. I know you think what I'm doing, but check it out, I'm doing some really good stuff here. Okay, YT and SB, and I'm just gonna need is F string, and then boom, we got SB and YT. Okay, so whenever YT is enter input, so it will be run this query, and from this query insert into YouTube, and in YouTube whenever you enter this name, it will be showing here, and subscriber name, it will be showing here. Let's try this code, and then I'm gonna just print successfully updated. Let's try this code, control shift F10. I'm gonna just enter YouTuber name. So let's say Ashish Chanchanani. Okay, and subscriber name, I don't know, Ashish Chanchanani has a lot of subscriber. I'm gonna name it Logan. Okay, boom, we got error. You have an error in SQL syntax that compromised your version. Okay, what we got error? We forget values. Okay, this is my problem. This is my mistake. Values. Let's try this again. Name is Ashish Chanchalani. And Logan. Boom, successfully updated. Let's see in our SQL we got or not. Let's reload this and select row. Oh, we forget something. Yeah. Remember I told you, whenever you write insert query, so you need to just do is db dot commit. Commit is gonna save our values. Okay, so let's try this last time. Ashish Chanchalani, I don't know spelling. Chanchalani, yes. And Logan. Okay, we got successfully updated. And let's now open MySQL. Let's refresh this. All. Open it. Select row. And boom, Ashish Chanchalani and Logan. We got our YouTubers and subscribers. We got user input in our database. So this is pretty simple. So we done a lot of stuff here. You remember I made a video about a GUI graphical user application in our Python. So you need to do is, this is your project, you need to write that application which can register and login. First, of course, obviously you need to make that application which can store your data like registration in username, password, email ID, and then when user login, so try to fetch that data and print successfully logged in. Okay, so this is your project, simple project. So that is it for today, guys. See you in the next video.